So one possible use of the Shortcuts app on the iPhone or iPad is to allow you to perform complex formulas over and over again and have it kind of a nice little programming environment where it prompts you for each thing. So as an example, let's say you're studying physics and you're using the position formula where you can take variables like the time, the initial position, velocity, acceleration, and figure out the position of a ball rolling on a table, a car rolling down a hill, a rocket shooting up into space. Here's what the formula looks like, and we're going to recreate that using Shortcuts. So get the Shortcuts app if you don't already have it in the iOS App Store. It's the one from Apple, of course, and I already have it there. At the bottom you see Physics Position Formula. But let me show you how to create at least the first few steps manually so you can see how I do it. So the first thing we want to do is we want to have a nice little asking interface where it asks for things. So we're going to search for ask for input, and I'm going to add that. And we'll do a question like, what is the time? And then we'll go ahead and set a initial value to 0 and change it to a number. Great. So we're going to have lots of inputs like that. Now we want to save this time variable. We'll put it into a variable here. So I'll do set variable. Now we could use the magic variables in there, but I think it for something like this it gets really complex pretty fast. So I think creating variables with names makes a lot of sense. So we'll do time. Great. So now it's going to ask you for the time and then you'll set it. If I run it here you can see what happens. It asks you for the time, what's the time, hit OK, and then that's it. So now we will go and do the next thing, which is going to ask again for a initial position. So ask for input. I'm just going to save some time here by typing position instead of ask for position. Default answer of 0. Very commonly when you do this kind of equation you're starting at 0. You know, the rocket's launching from the ground or whatever. So you have that. And then we'll do another set variable and we'll put that in the answer. Because what we're going to do is we'll start with the initial position and then we'll keep adding things to it. So we might as well just do that here. I could set it to initial position or something like that, but then I just have to add a bunch more steps to add that to the eventual answer. So we've got that. Now let's add another ask for input, and we'll this time ask for the velocity, the initial velocity of it, and we'll do a default answer of 0, number, and then we'll basically take that, we're going to run a calculation with it. There's no reason for us to store it in a variable because we can use it right away. So we'll do a calculate. And this is where it's really disappointing because it would be great if you could store all these inputs into variables and then do one little mathematical formula like you could do in a normal programming language. But here all you can do are these little calculations like you're using a calculator. So you can just do one calculation at a time. So what we're going to do with this one is we're going to multiply the velocity times the time. So we have the velocity coming out of that last input there. Now we have to multiply that. So we'll change it to multiply and we'll go and choose the variable time. So we're going to get the result of the velocity times the time. Now we're going to do another calculation. We're going to add that. Remember this is kind of like doing on a calculator, so the order of operations is kind of like you're going to do the multiplication first and then you're going to add it to the answer. Great. So now we have most of the equation done. Now we want to set a variable, and what we can do is basically give it the same name. We'll set the answer. So we're going to replace the answer with it. So that's what we got so far, part of it. I'm going to go and jump right here into the finished one so you can see what it looks like. And you can see here I'm doing things a little nicer. What is the time value? And I put in parentheses S for seconds, right? And then I set that to time. What is the initial position? In parentheses M for meters. And take that, put that in answer. What's the initial velocity? M over S, meters per second. And the number there. And then I do that calculation like we just did. Multiply that by the time and add the answer and then store it back in the answer. Now we're going to ask what's the acceleration? Meters per second squared. And we'll take that. We'll then calculate that times the time again because it's times time squared times 0.5 because you multiply by 1/2 And then we will add that to the answer. And no need to sort back in the answer because now we can just output it. I use Quick Look for the output. You could do Show Result and then have a nice little output of the result there. Quick Look does the trick. So I can run it now. I set it to a name, Physics Position Formula, gave it a little rocket ship icon. Said show it in the widgets, but I didn't really need it anywhere else. I didn't need to set Siri. I don't need to activate this with my voice. So now when I run it, it's going to ask what's the time value. So let's say it's 5 seconds. What's the initial position? Let's say 10 meters. What's the initial velocity? Let's say 15 meters per second. And what's the acceleration? Let's say 2 meters per second squared. And it's going to give me the result of 110. And if you run it through the formula, that's the correct answer. So now I can use this very quickly to calculate the position formula whenever I need.